Hello all, this is Dr. Alsup, and we have reached station number 26, so we are in the pelvis region. We're going to start with the basics of the pelvic girdle. So what are the bones that make up the pelvic girdle? What are the joints? What are some of the ligaments that we need to know? Then we'll get into, in station 27, the specifics of the coxal bones. Okay, so the pelvic girdle is going to be composed of two coxal bones, or two hip bones, which you can see this whole region here, all the way continuing around this region, is going to be one of the coxal bones, and then you'll have a mirroring one on the other side. And then this will be the sacrum. And the sacrum is going to be composed of typically five fused sacral vertebrae. So this bone is not going to have movement between the different vertebrae of the sacrum. You can see a bit of the coccyx down in this region, so sacrum and coccyx. The coccyx is not usually considered part of the pelvic girdle because it's not articulating with the coxal bones. It's just kind of that distal end of the vertebral column. It's also immovable. Now, we are going to have three joints. Two are of the same kind. You will have the sacroiliac joints, which I am circling right here. These sacroiliac joints, or your SI joints, are going to be between the auricular surfaces of the coxal bone and the sacrum. And this is going to be a compound joint, if you recall. So the majority of it is going to be a synovial joint, but the more posterior portions of the sacroiliac joint are actually going to be connected by fibrous tissue. So it will be a fibrous joint as well. Anteriorly, where the two coxal bones meet, is going to be the pubic symphysis. And so this is where the two pubis bones of the coxal bones meet. And there will only be one pubic symphysis per pelvic girdle. And this is a symphysis, so we know that a symphysis is a cartilaginous joint. So this is that cartilaginous joint that's right in this midline region associated with the anterior portion of the pelvic girdle. Okay, a few demarcation things that we need to note associated with the pelvic girdle. And the first is going to be the pelvic brim, which is sometimes referred to as the pelvic inlet. And this is going to be this bony edge that is going to separate the false pelvis from the true pelvis and is going to be the passageway or the inlet into the pelvic region. So this will extend from the sacral promontory region all the way around, kind of skirting around this top portion here to the top portion of the pubic symphysis and just continuing to make almost a complete circle here. So this is the pelvic brim or pelvic inlet. And anything that is superior to that pelvic inlet is going to be the false pelvis. So this kind of portion up in here would be part of the false pelvis. Same thing over in this region. And sometimes this is referred to as the greater pelvis because this is a larger area than we have in the true pelvis. The true pelvis is going to be any of this area inferior to the pelvic brim, but before you get to the pelvic outlet, which would be lower in this region here. So this pelvic, the true pelvis again, is going to be inferior to the inferior to the pelvic brim. Okay. Two ligaments that I want you to be able to identify, and we are looking at a lateral view of a very, very deep dissection of the pelvic girdle region, and you even see a bit of the femur right here. This is actually your gluteus minimus, which we will talk about in our second lab visit. This is the ilium portion of the coxal bone. And back here, you're going to have your ischial tuberosity, so part of the ischium. And so you can see that you have a ligament that is extending from the sacrum, which is kind of all covered up in this region here, but the sacrum is just deep to this. So from the sacrum to the ischial tuberosity will be the sacrotuberous ligament. And then you have this shorter ligament that is being covered up in some places by the sacrotuberous ligament. And this right here will be the sacrospinous ligament. So this extends from the sacrum to the ischial spine. And one thing I want you to note here is that with these ligaments, you have this creation of a foramen, because you have a little notch of bone right here, and then the ligaments kind of fill in the back. And this will be the greater sciatic foramen that allows for the exit of the sciatic nerve from the inside of the pelvis to outside in order for it to be able to innervate the good majority of the lower limb. Okay, excellent. So these are kind of the basics in terms of the pelvic girdle. In the next station, we will get into the specifics of the parts of the coxal bone and the sacrum. All right, thank you for your time here, and please always feel free to reach out with any questions.